Hello my friends, Rune here again from Oslo, Norway. And in this video, I want to try out my Umarex HDS68. You know this one that I tinkered a little bit with. I haven't adjusted the red dot sight. Not yet. And in this video, I want to try out some of the slugs I made using the Umarex mold. I made up a bunch of different slugs here, like these white ones. It has a steel BB in the front. It is made with floor leveling compound. But it takes forever to harden, so don't think I will bother to use that one again. Much quicker to use hot glue or candle wax. These ones are 67-68 grain. They vary a bit because some of the castings isn't perfect, like you see here. So, but around that weight. And here I have made of a candle wax, also with a steel BB in front. They weigh 42 grain, so quite lightweight. And the in-between weight is this, made with hot glue. This seems to hover around 54 grains in weight. Some are a little bit more, some are a little bit less, but around 54 grains. So let's try them out and see how fast they will shoot. I will use my X-ray dart only, and it reads between 100 feet per second and 399 feet per second. So I hope it will stay somewhere in between there. Silicone spray. Umarex brand CO2 canister. Sometimes it can be a bit fiddly getting it to enter the threads. Okay. And I have a tin can here. Let's see if we can make some holes in it. It is a thick, heavy gauge tin can. I cannot dent it or bend it with my fingers. But of course, I have shitty arthritis fingers. But let's see if we can make a hole in it. So, one moment. Okay. Trying a couple of shots with this floor leveling compound things. Let's see if I can get the chrono number for you and at the same time hit that can. Shooting from the hip, but let's see. .329. And big gaping hole. The shot did not survive. It shattered in a bunch of pieces. Second shot. .322. I hit the same spot or next to it, and it is just powder also. And now let's try the candle wax. 42 grain. Let's see if my chrono will read it. I think maybe it will fly over 400 feet per second, but we will see. Yes, over 400 feet per second. 0-0. And the hole got bigger, and the slug shattered that one too. I won't bother reading it, I'll just shoot at that tin can there. And it shattered too. But the hole got bigger. So, what about hot glue? ¼ grain, I think it was. Like so. Now we can try the chrono again, see if it will read. Just below 399. And it shot a hole out the back. And where's the slug? I don't know. There it is. So that one survived. The hot glue slugs normally survives. And that one did so. Let's try again, shooting next to it. .377. You can see the exit hole from the last shot there, that was one from the first shot. And here is the slug. Let's turn the camera a bit. Let's use the hot glue slugs because they seem to survive and they are also easier to load because they shrimp a bit when they get cold. The old ones was quite tight loading. There, it's about a meter or so away. .379. The BB fell off. And it impacted on the side of the tin can there. I think I just skipped the tin can because it has a lot of shattered remains from the floor leveling compound inside. Yes, I have one more shot. So, just shooting into my trap there. HDS68. And since it don't hit any hard objects, the slug survives nicely. 54 grain. Just to redo the number, 366. I think it's starting to drop on CO2 gas, maybe. Yes, 341. So, I took 6 more shots under the pillow just to empty out the pressure inside the marker. As you can hear, it has a small hiss now, leaking from the relief valve. Don't just unscrew the end plug, because that might ruin something inside. Push down the button here first. Like so. And quite interesting test. I was very surprised, because these one, they didn't load from the back. I couldn't push them into the rubber gasket. I had to muscle load them, and they were very, very tight. I really had to push the slug down from the muscle. So, yeah. I'm not sure how smart it is to use them. Maybe might break something in the marker. So I think I will stick with the hot glue. They seem to work fine. This one also works fine. You can load them from the back. But they shatter completely in a million small pieces when hitting something hard like the tin can. But my oh my, what a gaping hole or holes. Exit holes in the back. So, very cool marker. One day I will try to adjust this, and then we might do some accuracy testing. But I will have to adjust it first. And I don't think I can stand at home here to do so. I will need to be somewhere else. Yes. You can buy this marker here in Norway from Game On. And if you're using the coupon code RUNREBELL, you will get a 30% discount. Yes, and a big thanks to Florian Sølner from Home Defense 24 for supplying the Ammo 6 slug maker, and for giving me the red dot sight and the rail for the HDS68. So make sure you check out his website, homedefense24.com. Yes. Okay, that's it for today. Hope you liked the video. See you again another time, and thank you for watching.